Obligatory spoiler warning. Obviously, this video is going to be loaded with spoilers as we theorize what's to come in the next season. So if you haven't finished season 2 yet, this video probably isn't for you. Binge the season, then come back here when you're ready to dish. The Hargreaves may have handled the Handler, restored the Time Commission, and prevented the apocalypse, but they once again have botched the timeline. Season 2 left us and the audience just as confused as these adopted siblings, and we have a lot of possibilities when it comes to what's in store for them in Season 3. What's up, guys? I'm Chris Carr, and today I'm talking to you about what to expect in Season 3 of The Umbrella Academy. Before we dive in, I want to give a shout out to our super nerd sponsors of the day, Ares and Axel. Thanks to these heroes, I get to keep talking comics and binging shows with y'all. So thank you so much. All right, let the wild speculation begin! This past season brought us to Dallas, and brought us face to face with the inspiration for the Umbrella Academy's robotic mother, a young Southern scientist named Grace. Grace appears to have been the lead scientist on Operation Pogo, bonding with the ape and consequently the wealthy benefactor of his program, Reginald Hargreaves. When Pogo is severely injured, Reginald intervenes, injecting him with some sort of serum that immediately heals him, bringing him back from the brink of death. Whether or not this serum is what further enhances Pogo's intellect and speech abilities is unclear at this time, but the choice to step in leads to Grace and Reginald having a relationship, with Pogo serving as their surrogate child. Reginald even reads stories in ancient Greek to Pogo, just like he later would his adoptive, enhanced human children. When Grace learns that Reginald may be involved in some nefarious plot against the president, it would seem that she ends things with him. But again, we aren't entirely clear. Was Reginald Hargreaves desperately in love with this woman? Is that why he replicated her as mother? Did Diego's interference cause the two to break up prematurely, thus altering the timeline? I absolutely believe we'll be exploring a lot more when it comes to both Grace and her robotic counterpart. Circling back to Grace's project, this new timeline could also mean that Pogo is alive. It stands to reason that if Vanya wasn't raised a Hargreaves, and thus wasn't raised in the Hargreaves home, and consequently manipulated and abused, she wouldn't have had access to Pogo, or lashed out at him and killed him. Pogo could be very much alive, and I think we should be open to the possibility that any of our deceased characters from season 1 could be resurrected. Hazel may not have been shot. Agnes might not have gotten cancer. Heck, Cha-Cha could still be alive and Hazel and Agnes may never have met. In a show with elements of the fantastical and time travel twists, I never assume anyone is permadead. I mean, look at the Handler. She was shot point blank in the dome and she somehow survived that kill shot. This is why you always double tap, kids. Naturally, I think there's some really basic things we can count on in season 3, like a lot more will they, won't they moments with Luther and Allison. And now also with Diego and Lila, as they all continue to suss out if it's weird to have the hots for your sibling, who isn't technically your sibling. But as Klaus says, putting technically ahead of something already implies it's problematic. Fun fact, in the comics, Diego actually pines away in secret for Vanya. Now, in regards to the other kids, I think it's safe to bet on 5 dealing with the lingering side effects of Paradox psychosis in the next season, and Klaus will desperately need to connect with this very alive version of Ben. Speaking of which, of course the big WTF moment at the end of season 2 is that Ben is alive, Hargreaves never adopted the 6 other children we've come to know, and instead has raised a new team known as the Sparrow Academy. This alternate universe Ben feels like a blessing and a curse. I think it's safe to say we all fell in love with Ben and his naivety and his yearning for life experiences, like rolling in the dirt and rolling in the hay. Having more Ben seems like something we all would desperately want, especially after his touching moment of moving on to the next plane. But this emo-haired, get-out-of-my-house possible leader of the Sparrow Academy group seems like a real douche nozzle. And speaking of the Sparrow Academy, who even are these jabronis? In the comics, this group is hinted at in the finale of the Umbrella Academy arc, Hotel Oblivion. New heroes clad in red suits with a bird emblem come to the aid of the Umbrella Academy. They seem like a dream team. Their number one also has super strength, while the other members have powers like turning into a murderous raven, shooting laser beams from their eyes a la Cyclops. Another kinda looks like a booger and can inflict self-harm on him, but then his opponents can feel it? Honestly, that one sounds like a really horrible fellow. Could these folks be the mysterious members of the Sparrow Academy that we'll see in the show? And who exactly are they? Creator Gerard Way has a spin-off comic series due out called You Look Like Death. This comic follows Klaus in Los Angeles. Way claims that the spin-off is one piece in a larger puzzle explaining what happened in the 10 years before the Hargreaves were brought back together over their adoptive father's death. In an interview with Forbes, Way revealed that Volume 4 of the mainstream series would be entitled Sparrow Academy, saying, quote, "It deals with a very big reveal in the Umbrella Academy universe, something that had been secret for a long time, and our siblings learn a lot about what was happening behind the scenes, as well as discovering the true nature of some characters that have been with them since the beginning. The series finally starts to answer the question, what about the other babies born on that day? In that moment, the Umbrella Academy siblings are not alone in the world anymore. So I think we can certainly assume that we'll be learning a lot more of the who, what, and why when it comes to the special 43 children born on that day with powers. Why are they special? Why did Hargreaves round some of them up? Who trained these other ones? What the hell is going on? Speaking of other gifted children, we learn in season 2 that newcomer Lila was not only the adopted daughter of the Handler, who assassinated her parents in order to take her, but that she too possessed powers. In the season finale, Lila is shown using every power the Hargreaves have, claiming, anything you can do, I can do better. Oh, dip, y'all, we've got a rogue in our midst! We can definitely anticipate Lila's powers being explored more. Is her power that she can mimic a power she sees? Is it a power of redirection? Furthermore, I think we'll delve deep into her origins. Why did Lila have parents? Could no one convince them to put her up for adoption? Had they already been pregnant a full 9 months and therefore Lila wasn't deemed special or otherworldly? Why didn't anyone come for this girl until she was 4? Now, the Handler attempted a similar abduction with Harlan, the son of Vanya's love interest, Sissy. After saving Harlan from drowning, Vanya seemed to pass on her powers to the young boy and forge some deep bond with him. Harlan, a nonverbal child, even spoke as Vanya and as Ben when in this sort of white violin-possessed state. Vanya seemed to take away the majority of the power from Harlan. But as we saw, he could still levitate and move objects with his mind. Could Vanya's failure to remove Harlan's powers completely have been what disrupted the timeline? With a strong emphasis on everyone being capable of changing the world, and 5 really hammering the point that no one, not even a woman on a farm and her son, are insignificant, it's safe to assume that their interaction with Vanya could have drastically shifted things. Naturally, season 3 will take Vanya out to California to find Sissy. Sissy will at least be in her late 80s, if she's still alive, and Harlan will be older than Vanya. We'll more than likely see whether or not Sissy went out to California and started living her truth out and proud. And we'll see Harlan's powers develop beyond levitation, and possibly aid him in finding other ways to communicate with his mother. As Vanya stated in the series, in our time, there is a name for what Harlan has, and over time, he could get better treatment than what was initially available in Dallas in 1963. With the right ABA therapy, Harlan could grow to be a stronger, more effective nonverbal communicator. But with his powers left unchecked, much like Vanya, he could also grow to be a danger that the Umbrella Academy must address. The thing I'm perhaps looking most forward to is learning more about Hargreaves himself. We finally get the payoff from season 1 of Hargreaves having been from another world when he unzips his human suit in season 2. Ugh, you guys, I have been waiting so long for this. We learn he's an alien on like page 2 of the first issue of the comics. I'm guessing we'll be expanding on Hargreaves' alien origins, explaining just exactly what was happening in that season 1 flashback, and learn more of what brings him to Earth and makes him decide to take in these children. I'm also curious as to whether or not the show will ever utilize Hargreaves' monocle, or if it already has. In the comics, this bit of eyewear allows Hargreaves, or whoever's using it, to look into a person's true nature. Seems like a pretty handy plot device, and could be why he's always adjusting it as he peers through it, like when he was checking out 5 in the closet. And what exactly are Hargreaves' intentions with the dark side of the moon? It has to be something very important, since it led to him joining the Majestic 12. Was Luther's mission there not a total waste of time? Perhaps it could provide the setting for the Hotel Oblivion. In the comic arc of the same name, the hotel was built by Hargreaves on a distant planet that served as a prison for criminals taken in by the Umbrella Academy. It turned out that the hotel wasn't just a prison, though. It was an Abraxan, a trap meant to capture a cosmic monster that wanted to breach through the afterspace and come to Earth. The villains imprisoned in Hotel Oblivion were merely bait meant to lure the creature. Perhaps the show will swap the distant planet location for the dark side of the moon, but only time will tell if that's where things end up. All we can expect without a shadow of a doubt is more daddy issues and a dance sequence. Of course, these are just my thoughts and theories for season 3. The question is, what do you guys think is gonna happen? Am I totally off base on some of these? Do you have a different thought? Hit me with your hot takes in the comments below. If you liked this video, well then give it a like, bud. And be sure you hit that subscribe button and bell so we can keep the comics conversation going, and let me know what comic coverage you want next. Thanks for watching, you guys. See you, Space Cowboy.